Brothers, sisters, friends, welcome to Central Christian Church.
弟兄姐妹朋友们，大家好，欢迎们来到中央基督教会。
And happy Mother's Day.
祝大家母亲节快乐。
Appreciate the youth and their dedication that they did for Mother's Day.
然后很感激我们的青少年为这一个母亲节带来特别的演出。
Okay, mothers are special people, right?
Yeah. 母亲们是很特别、很重要的
of course, 分子。 Fathers are special people too.
当然，父亲也是很重要的。
Okay, they have to wait their turn, I think, next month, right?
Yeah. 可是呢，他们得耐心的等候，因为他们的庆祝下个月才会来。
Okay, sometimes we forget about the fathers, right?
有时候我们很容易的就忘记了父亲。
Okay. So, you know, mothers put has a special place in all our hearts.
然后母亲呢，其实在我们每个人的心里面上呢，是占据着很特别、很重要的一个部分。
And no matter how they are like, you know, whether they are very strong mothers or very soft mothers, they are always very special to us.
不管他们是什么性格的，有些可能是很坚强、很强悍的，有一些可能是很温柔、很体贴的，他们还是在我们生命里面占据一个非常重要的一个角色。So
today I entitled my lesson, Mother.
Wow. 然后今天呢，我们传道的主题就是母亲。
So we're gonna read a scripture from the book of Proverbs, chapter 31. Verse 10 to 12, and then we're going to jump and skip to verse 25 to 30. I'll let KK read in Chinese.
然后我们翻开我们的圣经上去到箴言书第31章第10节到第12节，然后我们跳到25到30。所以第10节，才德的妇人谁能得着呢？她的价值远胜过珍珠，她丈夫心里依靠她，必不缺少利益。 她一生使丈夫有益无损，然后第25节，能力和威仪是她的衣服。她想到日后的境况，就喜笑。她开口就发智慧，她时尚有仁慈的法则。她观察家务，并不吃闲饭。她的儿女起来称她有福，她的丈夫也。 称赞她说：“才的女子很多，唯独你超过一切。艳丽是虚假的，美容是虚浮的。唯敬畏耶和华的妇女必得称赞。” So
here is the Bible description of the perfect mother.
然后这里呢，圣经描绘了完美母亲的角色。
You know, in God's eyes, mothers are special.
然后在神的眼里呢，母亲是特别的。
Again, all of us, we strive, especially the mothers, we strive to become a woman like that.
然后特别是母亲们，我们所有人都努力的想要成为神眼中的完美母亲。
You know, when I think about mothers, I feel a little bit emotional.
每当我想到母亲的时候，我心里总是有点激动。
I can remember the time when I was young and I have a lot of good times with my mother.
然后让我想起的就是我小时候的时候，我有很多和母亲的美好回忆。
It's, you know, my father would give me a lot of instruction and teaching, but it's my mother that we form a lot of connection and we spend a lot of time together.
然后我父亲呢，基本上会给我很多指示跟教导。 反正我的母亲会花很多的时间和我培养那个关系。
You know, I will remember the times when during the weekends, I would go to the market with my mother.
我记得就是在周末的时候，我会和我母亲是吗，去到市场那边。
You know, and I would, at the market, I'll watch her shopping, bargaining for the meat, the vegetable, and it is just such a delight just to be with her and watch her doing her marketing.
所以我还记得，就是当我们去到那一个菜市场的时候，啊 总是看到母亲是吗，在和那些商贩那边讨价还价，买菜也好，买肉也好，总之任何买东西是吗，都想在讨价还价。然后这让我想起，就是说看到他这么样为家庭省钱为家庭就是说服务是多么的开心。
You know, even though we don't talk very much, but it's just special just to be with her and to watch her doing her marketing.
然后虽然就是说在那过程中是吧，我并没有跟她讲很多的话，或者是有很多的沟通，可是看着她就是买东西在那边讨价还价是吧，对我来讲是一种美好的回忆，一种享受。
And then of course, you know, sometimes you walk past the clothing shop, and then she will always stop, you know, to see if there's any clothing she can buy for me.
然后当然每当就是我们路过那个服装店的时候是吗，她总是会把脚步停下来的，然后她总是会看看就说有什么服装可以买的，可是不是买给她自己，而是买给孩子们。
Again, you know, and of course my mom, all right, being somebody who cares for me very much, she's also very strict with me.
然后当然我的母亲虽然说是非常有爱心有耐心的人，可是她对我们说也是非常严格的。
Between my mom and dad, I get more discipline, more punishment for discipline from my mother.
然后在我父母之间是吗，其实我母亲对我的惩罚还是教训来的比父亲多。
You know, but one thing I already appreciate about my mom is that after every discipline, she will always come to me and, you know, gently give me a hug and tells me that she loves me very much. She disciplined me because she really cares.
所以，可是有一个东西我很珍惜我母亲的，就是不管她有多生气，她惩罚了我过后是吗？他总是会就是说紧紧地拥抱着我，然后告诉我就是说我爱你然后这些惩罚是为了你更好。
So after she informs me, she tells me she really loves me and cares for me, you know, all the pain of discipline just evaporated.
然后当他告诉我就是说他有多爱我的时候是吧，那他之前惩罚我的那种肉体的痛是吧，就忘记到了。
Okay, so moms, very special, right?
所以母亲们，你们都很特别吧
？Okay, so today I dedicate my message to mothers, Mother's Day special.
所以今天我把传道是吗献给所有的母亲。
No discount, unfortunately.
可惜这边并没有折扣。
So, but we're going to talk about how can we, again, in our relationship, in our family, be better mothers, husbands to our wives and children.
然后今天呢，我们就要探讨，就是我们的家庭关系里面是吧，我们怎么样可以变得一个更好的母亲、丈夫或者是孩子。
Because no matter what, we want to have good relationship in our families, right?
然后不管怎么样，就是我们都渴望我们家庭有一个融洽美好的关系。
And no matter where you are at, some families are great in their relationship, some are not so good. No matter where you are at, we can all always improve.
那不管你的家庭关系到底是好还是欠佳这样等等样好消息就是我们总是有机会是吗来改善这个关系。
Okay, so let's start with children.
那我们以孩子开始吧。
So children, okay, you know, let's look at how can we show our love and respect to our mothers.
然后孩子们让我们看看这样我们怎么能够就是展示出我们对我们母亲的爱与尊重。
Okay, so this don't just don't just apply to the youth in front here, you know, apply to all of us because every one of us have mothers.
Okay, 然后这一个是吗不单单的只是告诉我们这边的青少年而已，而是全部人，因为我相信我们每一个人都有妈妈。
Okay, soLet's see what the Bible teaches how we can improve in our love and respect for our mothers.
然后我们今天就探讨，就是在圣经里面，我们怎么样能够改善对母亲的爱和尊重。
So let's turn our Bible to Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 to 3.
然后我们翻开我们的圣经，去到以弗所书第六章第一节到第三节，你们做儿女的。要在主里听从父母， 这是理所当然的。要孝敬父母，使你得福，在世长寿，这是第一条应带应许的诫命。
Okay, so the Bible says here, honor your father and your mother.
然后圣经里面这边谈到，就是要尊重，要听从你的父亲和母亲。
You know, to honor, the meaning of that is to what? To prize or to put something of, to put a value, to a high value towards something or somebody.
在这里英文字尊重或者是孝敬这个字是吗？其实是把最有价值或者是把最重要的那一个礼遇还是待遇是吗？付出给对方。
So as you can see, you know, God always value a family relationship.
所以你可以看到就是神是吗？一直以来都非常注重非常珍惜家庭关系。
If you notice, it doesn't say honor your mother or your father when they are good to you.
然后你要注意看就是说圣经从来没有说就是说尊重你父母当他们还是好的时候。
Okay, I know obviously some of us, our parents, okay, might not be that nice, okay, might not be that good to us, correct?
然后当然我们当中可能有一些人的父母是吗并没有就是说善待我们或者是并没有做一个好的榜样。
And sometimes our mothers can be, you know, some of our mothers can be very harsh.
有一些母亲是吗有时候也可以很严苛。
Or some of them, being so busy as they are, they neglect us.
又或者有些父母呢生活真的是太忙了忙到就是忽略了孩子。
But the Bible still say, you know, you still need to honor your mother.
可是圣经是吗却还是说我们还是需要尊敬我们的父母。
It doesn't mean that we have to accept their behaviors.Obviously.
然后并不代表就是我们得接受他们的那一个行为举止。
Okay, when they are harsh towards us or when they neglect us, it doesn't mean you feel like, oh, that's okay to be harsh towards me. So God is not saying to accept their behaviors.
所以这并不代表就是说当他对你太过严苛或者是他忽略你的时候是吧你告诉你自己就说这一切是正常的我得接受了神并没有叫我们接受他们错的那一种行为举止
Okay, but we can honor and value them as an individual, as a person
可是我们说却还是需要作为一个孩子去尊重父母特别是他们作为我们父母的一个身份
So you might think, how can we do that? You know, but I don't like her
然后你可能就没问你自己就说你叫我怎么样做到我这么的不喜欢他你叫我怎么做
Again, obviously we hope that you do like your mother but you know you find that in life sometimes you can still honor somebody even if you don't like them
然后当然我们绝大部分人都喜欢我们的父母然后可是你会发现在我们生命里面是吗有时候在我们不喜欢的一些情况之下我们还是可以选择去尊重别人
Okay, think about it How many of us we like our boss
你想想的话我们当中有没有人喜欢你的老板啊
Okay, most of us don't like our boss, right?
我们多数人都不喜欢我们老板对不对
Okay, because we always get scolded and always make us work super hard and pay us very little bit
因为他整天骂我们然后逼我们加班做得很辛苦然后给我们一点点的工钱而已
But yet we honor them as our boss
可是呢我们还是尊重他作为我们的上司还是老板
Okay kids how many of you love your teachers
孩子们你们当中有几个人很喜欢你的老师
Okay maybe certain teachers you really like but majority you kind of feel like oh man this teacherSo hard, so much homework. Always scold me because I don't do well.
然后 你可能会喜欢一两个还是一些的老师，可是绝大部分的老师是吗？啊，可能大多数的孩子都不会喜欢的。你可能会觉得，哇，这些老师是吗？都太过严厉了，然后整天在那边骂我，又没有教功课，然后又给了我一大堆的功课。
Okay, but yet we still honor them and respect them. When you see them, you still say, "Hello, teacher. Yes, teacher." What do you want me to do, teacher? Okay, teacher. Right? We still honor them.
可是呢，我们是吧？在面对老师的时候，是吗？我们还是尊敬他。所以遇到他的时候，是吧？我们就会讲，哎，老师早安，谢谢老师啊，有什么东西叫我做呢？等等。
Okay, so you find that you know you can honor the mother, even though you might not like their behavior.
所以啊，从此借鉴的话，是吗？其实我们也可以选择，就是说尊重我们的父母，哪怕有时候你不喜欢他们。
But hopefully, as you honor them, hopefully your relationship with your mother again will get closer.
然后当我们啊、尊重我们的父母的时候，希望在这个过程中是吗？啊、你和你父母的关系会改善。
Okay, so let's see how to do it. All right.So the way we're going to look at it is we're going to look at how did Jesus honor his mother.
所以要怎么样做呢？今天呢，我们就要探讨耶稣怎么样去尊重他的母亲。
Sometimes you know, we think Jesus' mother is perfect. You know?
那有时候我们可能有这一个、想法，就是哇、哦，耶稣的母亲是吗？应该是完美的。
Jesus' mother was never perfect.
可是呢，现实呢，耶稣的那个母亲是吗？是不完美的。
She actually, if you read the Bible carefully, she actually has very high unrelenting standard.
啊，如果你啊、注意还是细心的去读那些圣经的话是吗？你会发现到耶稣的母亲是吗？对啊、她有一个非常超标的那个期
望。Okay.You know, in John 2, right? You're not going to turn there. But at a wedding party, somebody else's wedding party, Jesus' mother approached Jesus. Mary approached Jesus and said, Son, I know it's somebody else's party, but I want you to turn this water into wine.
然后 OK, 我们就、看回圣经、约翰、第二章这样。然后耶稣跟他的母亲说出席了一个宴会。别人的那个结婚宴会，然后在宴会进行当中是吗？他的母亲要求耶稣，就是说啊，帮这一个啊主婚人是吗？啊，准备那个酒。
Okay, because Mary knows that Jesus has the ability, but even though you know, but it's not Jesus's party. Yet she expects Jesus to do something about somebody else's problem.
然后你会当然耶稣的母亲是吗？知道就是耶稣他有那一个能力，他有那一个方法。可是要知道就是说这个是别人的那个宴会，别人的那个结婚喜宴。可是他的母亲是吗？还是期待，还是期盼他在别人的那一个问题是吧？帮他们解决的问题。
I mean, how do you like that? Okay, you go to a wedding party, you know, wedding dinner, and then midway through the wedding dinner.You know, your friend run out of you know, money or whatever. And then your mother say, hey, son, this person no more money, you know. Or maybe at the end, right? 算账啊 at the end. Hey, son, they still owe down $10,000, you know. 10,000 ringgit. Son, I want you to pay. You pay for him. How do you want it?
所以你可以想象一下，如果你、跟你母亲是吗去出席一个、结婚那个喜宴。然后到这个结婚喜宴完的时候是吗？过后这一个那个新郎官是吗？打开所有的红包，就发现说，哎，钱不够了。然后你妈妈就跟你讲，就说，嘿，你的这个啊、新郎官是吗？还欠了10,000块的红包钱，哎，你帮他还，你会有什么感受
？Okay, I mean, you know, doesn't matter whether you are rich or you know whatever. You could be a very rich man, but to pay for someone else, I know I will get a bad attitude. It's like, well, mom.So my buddy.
所以呢，不管你是有钱啊，还是啊比较普通的一个人的话，是吧？啊，当你被要求就是说为啊别人买单， 付账的时候啊，那个是你自己的血汗钱了、啊，所以你肯定是嘛会对这个有一点不满的。
Okay, and here's another situation in Mark chapter 3, when Jesus was busy, one of his busiest days doing his ministry. You know, he ran out of time to eat. You know what his mother called him?
然后啊，还有另外一个情况，就是在马克第三章的时候，就马克在啊忙着那一个传道的时候，对不起，耶稣在忙着那个传道的时候是吗？在他最忙的时候，他的妈妈是吗？竟然为他对他提出一个要求，你猜他要求什么？
You know, the mom said, wow, my son, crazy, really. Dinner also don't eat.
他的妈妈玛丽就说，哇，我的儿子发疯了，连晚餐都不要吃。
Okay, but of course, you know, the mother said that because the intention is out of love, out of concern. But you know, moms can be that way, right? Because they care for you so much, they scold you.
那当然我们都知道就是说玛丽会这么样、说呢，是因为她出自于她对耶稣的关怀，对耶稣的爱。可是有时候因为他们的爱是吗，他们、也会、用折策的那个行动是吗表现出来。
Okay, so Jesus' mother not perfect, yet Jesus learned to honor his mother, learned to honor his mother.
所以呢，耶稣的母亲玛丽并不是一个完美的女人，可是耶稣呢，还是选择啊学习尊重他的母亲。
So let's turn to Luke chapter 2, verse 46 to 51, and let's see how did Jesus love and honor his mother.
好，我们翻开我们圣经，去到路加第二章第46节到第51节，我们看看耶稣怎么样去尊重他的母亲。第四十六节，过了三天，就遇见他在殿里，坐在教室中间，一面听，一面问。凡听见他的，都稀奇他的聪明和他的应对。他父母看见，就很稀奇。他母亲对他说：“我儿，为什么像我们这样行呢？看啊，你父亲和我伤心来找你。”耶稣说：“为什么找我呢？岂不知我应当以我父的事为念吗？他所说的这话他们不明白，他就同他们下去回到那撒勒，并顺从他们。他母亲把这一切的事都存在心里。
Okay, so we, you know the background, they went to the temple to worship, and then the parents left, but Jesus stayed behind.
所以啊，你们可能都知道他的背景，这个故事呢，就是啊。他和他的父母去到那个神殿敬拜，然后过后他的父母是吗就离开了神殿，可是耶稣呢却待下来。
And then after 3 days, I don't know why after 3 days, okay? So the mom, the parents must be quite absent-minded. After these three, only after 3 days, then she discovered, see, her mother not perfect, right? Missing for 3 days, still not worried.
所以啊，很奇怪的就是。三天过后，我不知道为什么是三天过后，所以你会发现到什么？他的父母啊是有点，就是说 special， 就这样啊、有点啊、大头虾，就是说不懂为什么三天过后才发现，哎，他的孩子竟然没有回到来。
So anyway, they got worried, okay, and they decided to look for Jesus, and of course they finally found Jesus, boy Jesus, 12-year-old, in the temple.
然后 OK， 不管怎么样呢，就是说三天过后他们开始就紧张了，结果呢他们就。在那个神殿里面、啊、找到了那时还在12岁的耶稣。
Okay, so you can imagine the scene.、Jesus' mother saw Jesus in the temple court. How do you think she reacted?
所以、我们就看到了这一个场景呢，就是当耶稣看、当耶稣的母亲是吧看到耶稣的时候啊，她怎么反应的
？Okay, she's probably you know scolding Jesus. Jesus, what are you doing? You know we've been looking for you for 3 days. You in the temple court.Okay, she was probably very angry with Jesus.
所以她可能就是这么反应的啊，就说啊、哦，你为什么会在神殿里面？我已经花了三天在那边找你了，你知道我有多担心吗
？Okay, but I appreciate Jesus, right? Very calmly, he answered his mother. Didn't you know I've been in my father's house?
然后可是我啊、我很珍惜就是耶稣这么样尊重他母亲，就是说他这么样很平服的。就是回答他母亲，就说你不知道我在神殿里面为神服侍吗？
Because Jesus, right? He has a duty, a responsibility, you know, to be there to teach the people, okay, or to learn and to help the people. So he's telling his mom, I have to be here.
所以因为耶稣呢，在神殿里面有义务，就是要教导啊，要帮助啊那边的那些信徒。所以他告诉他的母亲，就是我有那一个啊义务在身。Okay,
so my first point. All right. Jesus, how did he honor his mother? How did he show respect? Jesus' spirituality inspired his mother.
所以啊，这就来到我的第一点呢，就是耶稣怎么样去。 展示他对母亲的一个尊重呢，就是耶稣的属灵是吗？啊，激励了他母亲。
Okay, it says here at the end, even though the mom was anxious, even though the mother kind of scolded him, but at the end, the mother treasured all these things in her heart.
然后啊，虽然讲啊，我们回到就是那个经节的最后一节那样。 虽然说他的母亲很激动、很生气，甚至可能是骂了他，可是到最后是吧，他母亲却很珍惜耶稣所说的一切，然后把它放在心上。
So again, I could see the scenario, you know, when Jesus' mother saw Jesus after scolding him, after letting go of emotion, right? Women always got a lot of emotion, right? Then she put in her heart, wow, my son, he is so righteous. He is a man of integrity. I can quite respect him and trust him that he'll grow up to be a very responsible person.
所以你可以想象呢，就是说，在他母亲玛丽发泄了他的那一个愤怒啊，又或是他的紧张过是吗？当他心情平复起来的时候是吗？他却可以发现到，就是说，哇，我的孩子是一个正直感。 然后有公义的一个孩子，所以我尊重他，我相信他将来成长过后什么，将会成为一个正直的人。Okay,
you think about it, right? Why does our mothers scold us sometimes? Isn't it?
所以你想想这样，为什么我们的母亲是吧，有时在骂我们呢？
Isn't it because they want us to grow up to become good people?
然后到头来，你会问自己说，是不是他们希望我们长大了会成为一个有用的人呢？Okay,
I'm not saying their methods are okay. Sometimes their methods are wrong, which they need to change. But you know, they want us to grow up to be responsible, good individual that can take care of our own lives and can take care of and help other people's life and also take care of their life when they grow older.
当然，我不是说，就是说所有的母亲的那个方法都是对的，然后有时候他们的方法是错的。可是无可置疑的，就是他们的用心还是他们的初衷是吧，都是为了就是说教导我们，希望孩子们成长后成为有用的人，能够照顾好自己，同时也可以帮助到别人的。You
know, Jesus's what? His righteousness, his integrity, his spirituality, at the very end, inspired his mother.
所以呢，耶稣呢，就是以他的那一个正直，以他的公义，以他的那一个属灵，到最后感动了他的母亲，同时也尊重了他母亲。Okay,
how do we know that? Because what? Jesus' mother followed Jesus everywhere Jesus went.
那我们怎么知道呢？你会发现到，就是说，圣经记载。 他的母亲是吧，一直追随着耶稣的脚步。And
Jesus's mother became one of Jesus' most faithful
disciple.然后，耶稣的母亲呢，成了耶稣他最忠心的追随者。Okay,
notice here, Jesus's mother didn't tell Jesus that she was fired up about him.
你发现到就是说，耶稣的母亲从来没有讲，就是说哇，他很高兴，他孩子的成就还是作为。Okay,
but she kept it in her heart.
可是呢，他把这一切的喜悦还是这一种满足，藏在心里面。So
your righteousness, your integrity, okay, your responsibility, your spirituality. Mean something to your parents.
所以你的那一个正义感，你的那一个公义感，你的正直，还有你的那个属灵是吗？对你父母是有一定的意义的。
You know, if they might not tell you, but in their heart, they will recognize it.
所以他们可能口头上是吗？不会表达出来，不会告诉你，不会称赞你。可是啊、他们心里面是吗？是有所感动的，然后对你是有所尊敬的。
Okay, I remember when I first met my wife, Patrice, and we obviously I love her, and so we went to meet her parents.
然后我还记得就是我第一次当我就是说第一次遇上那个 Patrice 的时候，然后很明显的我就爱上她了。然后有一次我就去就是说面见她的父母。
You know, the first meeting didn't go very well.
知道吗？我们第一次见面的时候是吗？其实并不是一个很好的开始。
Okay, because I'm a Christian and they know that we want to come back to Asia for mission, so they were not fired up for a few reasons. Number one, I'm Asian. Number two, we are coming to coming back here to for the ministry for mission.
然后为什么是吗？一开始不好呢？因为他的父母知道，就是说，第一，我是一个亚洲人；第二，就是说，当我们在一起过后是吗？我们会回来亚洲这一边是吗？服侍神这样，所以他们一开始就不是有对这件事不是很好感。
Okay, her parents are good people, but you know, one of the things that they exclaimed was, they told my wife later on, "Where are you going to live on the treetop?" You know, missionary very poor. They live on the treetop in the jungles.I mean, that was the impression of missionaries like that.
然后，他的父母说啊，私底下有一次就是跟 Patrice 嘛这么讲，就是说啊，你如果是嘛卫生服侍的话是嘛，你会住在哪里？你要想要住在那个树上吗？因为他们有一些就是说固有的那个想法，他认为就是说服侍神的在卫生事工的那些人是嘛，都活得很穷这样，所以得活在树上。
You know, so anyway, okay, you can see their impression. I was probably in the last place in their, okay, in terms of, what you call, respectability, in the beginning, last place.
所以当我看到他们的那一个面孔，还是那个反应的时候是吗？我感觉到就是说，他对我的尊重是吗？可能是排到最后一位的。
But, you know, after many years, you know, being with my wife, having kids,After many years, and we always go back to see them, okay? At the very end, to my surprise and to my happiness, that it turned out, I become first place in your eyes. Wow.
然后当然这些年下来过后是吗？当我们结婚了，我们有孩子了，然后间中我们也时常就是说回去探望他们，然后很出乎我意外的，然后也我很高兴的，就是说他们对我的尊重是吗？基本上已经是排到第一位了。
Okay, I became my in-law's favorite, what you call, son-in-law. They have three son-in-law, I'm the favorite one.
然后结果呢，我成为了就是说我岳父岳母们最喜欢的那个女婿，然后他们有三个女婿，然后他们我是排在第一的。
Okay, because they saw our integrity, they saw our marriage was very strong. I really love my wife. All right, I don't cheat on her. Okay, and not only that, you know, they saw the way we raise up our children. They respect that. Okay, you see, you know, parents, in your heart, respect your integrity and your righteousness.
然后他们都很就是说欣赏我们的婚姻。然后很明显的就是我很爱我太太我并没有欺骗她，同时他们也就是很欣赏我们怎么样去教养孩子的，所以我们的这一些正直感，我们这一些公益感是吗？到头来感动了他们，然后让他们尊重我们。
Okay, so my first point, inspire your mother, honor her with your faith, your integrity, your righteousness, your responsibility.
所以呢，第一点呢，就是尊敬你们的母亲、你们的父母，然后激励他们，以你的那一个正义感、 以你的那一个责任感跟你的属灵去尊重他们，然后记忆他们。
Okay, what else? How else did Jesus honor his mother?
然后啊、耶稣还在什么方面上啊去尊重他的母亲呢？
Okay, well, here it says in the same passage, then Jesus went down to Nazareth with them and was what? Obedient to them.
然后啊、我们就回到那一个第五十节，就是啊、耶稣同他们一起下去回到拿撒勒并顺从他们。
Okay, Jesus is the Lord of everyone, even the Lord of his mother. But yet, he was submissive to his mother's instruction.
然后耶稣呢是万物之主，然后他也是他母亲的主人，可是他还是愿意就是啊、顺服啊、他母亲的那一个指示。
You know, he was obedient, and、as long as it doesn't go against God.
然后他是非常顺服他母亲、除非 他母亲的那一个旨意是吗？是违反神的那个意愿。
Okay, so I'm not saying if your mother say, hey, go rob a bank, then you go for it. I'm not saying that.Okay, or your mom said, hey, don't go to church this Sunday. Then you say, okay, I won't go to church. That's not what we are saying here.
然后、我这边不是跟你讲的那种愚孝，也就是说你母亲叫你去打抢银行的话，你讲 okay, 好，我听话，我去打抢银行。又或者是母亲告诉你说啊，这个礼拜天你不要去教会啦，留下来陪我，帮我做东西这样啦，然后你就跟着不去了。我们不是说这一些。
You know, but in other things, Jesus was very obedient and submissive to his mother.
然后可是呢在其他的那些地方呢其他的领域呢母、耶稣是吗是非常顺从他的母亲。
Okay, this is our challenge. We are human beings. We love our independence.
然后这是我们的挑战啊我们人都很喜欢我们的那一个自由。
Right, especially growing up as teenagers, right? We want our freedom!
然后特别是、当我们成长到我们青好像青少年这样、我们都渴望我们的自由。
I mean, even adults, we want our freedom, right? Freedom, mother, don't tell me what to do, you know? 、
不当然是孩子而已、即使是成人的话是吗有时候我们也是很渴望我们的自由。这样妈妈不要再唠叨了不要再叫我做什么了。
Okay, so, but of course, as you grow up, you need to learn how to be independent, okay, and not to be reliant of your mother.Alright, you need to have your own autonomy.
然后当然成长过程中的话我们都得要学习就是我们怎么样独立、不要过分的依赖我们的母亲。然后我们也要学习就是要怎么样去、保持、建立自己的自主权。
So what do we mean here by obedient?
那这边顺从又是什么意思呢？
There is a difference between obedience and subjugation.
Okay, 然后顺从跟盲从是有分别的。
Okay, obedience is because you love and honor your mother.
然后顺服呢，是因为你爱跟尊重你的母亲。
Or because you love and you honor God.
又或者是因为你爱而顺服神。
So subjugation.Is you follow instruction because what? You are afraid of disapproval, you are afraid of rejection, or you are afraid of punishment.
盲从呢，反而就是你遵从指示，因为你害怕或者是你担心别人的那个批判。
Okay, and so often, this is the reason why a lot of us, we don't like to obey or submit because, what, we, for longest time, subjugate ourselves and follow instruction because we do not want to be disapproved by our mother.
这就是我们的问题了。很多时候我们都不喜欢、顺服我们的父母因为我们觉得我们在盲从我们 担心我们的母亲是吗？不会对我们有对我们的那个决定是吗？喜欢。
Okay, because we hear so many threats. You don't obey me, I don't love you. You don't obey me, get out of the house. You don't obey me, I'm gonna do this to you. Right? That's what we hear. And so, in our mind, obedience has become a very negative word.
因为我们听到很多的那一些威胁的，你可能听到母亲威胁，如果你再不听我的话的话，是吗？我就不爱你了。又或者是，如果你不听我的话，是吗？我就把你赶出街了。然后，如果或者是你不听我的话，是吗？我不给你零用钱等等的。就是因为这一些威胁之下，是吗？我们就很讨厌顺服，然后选择了盲从，因为我们没有那一个自力更生的能力。
Okay, so what we need to learn, what? We need to learn to what? Obey because we love.
所以呢，我们应该学习，我们学习顺服，因为我们爱。
You know, even as adult, you find yourself being subjugated. You're still doing a lot of things because you don't want to hurt your mother's feeling. You're probably, what? You're having subjugation. You need to learn to what? Let go of seeking approval.
所以哪怕是成人的话，是吧？有时候我们也是活在就是盲从的那个阴影之下啊，我们不懂得怎么样去拒绝啊，因为我们不想要伤害我们的母亲，又或者是我们不想要就是啊，让我们母亲不开心。
Okay, the good news is, as human being, we all can learn to. You have the choice to say no.
啊，好消息呢，其实是。我们都有权利有机会去说不。
So if you are somebody who is very subjugated, you can say no. Okay, you can learn to say no when the instruction is offensive towards you.
所以呢，如果你本性是比较偏向盲从的那一些的话，是吗？你可以选择去拒绝那个指示，还是拒绝那个要求？当这一个指示是对你有伤害
，Okay, but guess what? You can say yes because what? Mom, I'm willing to do this for you because I love you.
然后同时呢，我们也可以选择说是选择服从啊，因为啊，你可以说就是妈。我愿意去做这一个，因为我爱你。
Okay, you know, there's so much freedom, you know, when you do it because out of love.
然后当你本着爱去做决定的时候，是吗？你就会发现到你有非常大的自由度。
Because it is now your choice to do it, because it is your heart who cares.
因为这个时候是吗？就是你的选择了，然后你是可以随心所欲的。
Okay, so that's the second thing. Honor your mother with your godly submission and obedience, because freedom comes through godly submission.
然后这就是我们第二点，我们可以以属灵或者是属神的那个顺服来尊重我们的母亲，因为尊重可以从服从那一边显现出来。
Of course, now if you're an adult, you find it very hard. That's because there's a lot of hurt and bitterness, and that's something that you need to find someone, you know, to talk through, to deal with your pain of the past, so that what you can learn to re-love your mother.
所以呢，当然，我们当中可能有一些年长或者是成人的话，是吗？会发现到很难做得到，那是因为我们过去是吗所受到的一些伤害造成的一些苦。造成我们有对这个顺服有一个排斥，有一个拒绝感，然后所以呢，这个时候呢，就要鼓励你，就是找一个人跟你谈，挖出你的那一些伤害、那种苦毒的那种感觉，然后通过这一个人是吧，来帮助你去克服这一些苦毒。
Okay, that's why studying the Bible very important, right? Because through the Bible, you can learn what forgiveness.
所以读圣经是非常重要，灵修是非常重要的，因为通过圣经我们可以学到宽恕。
Alright, thirdly, how did Jesus learn to honor? How did Jesus honor his mother?
然后第三点， 耶稣还可以啊，还用了什么方法去尊重他的母亲呢？
John 19 verse 25 to 27。
我们把圣经翻到约翰第十九章啊，25-27节，25节，站在耶稣十字架旁边的有他母亲和他母亲的妹妹，并格罗巴的妻子玛利亚和莫大拉的玛利亚。耶稣见母亲和他所爱的门徒站在旁边，就对他母亲说：“母亲，看你的儿子。”又对那门徒说：“看你的母亲。”从此，那门徒就接他到自己家里去了。
Okay, this is when Jesus was on the cross. You know, you gotta appreciate Jesus, even at the last point of his life, when he was suffering, he is still thinking about his mother.
然后这个时刻呢，耶稣呢是在十字架上面，所以我们不得不佩服耶稣，就是说到了他生命走到最后的一刻是吧，他还是有心思去尊重他的母亲。
You know, Jesus was very selfless.
然后耶稣是吧，他是非常无私的。
You know, throughout Jesus' life, you know, the father was not around because Joseph passed away. Guess what? When there was no Joseph, who took care of the family? Jesus took care of all the needs.
然后在耶稣的生命当中是吗？其实他的父亲约瑟是吗？就很早就已经过世了，所以他就是活在没有父亲的环境之下成长的。然后他母亲是吗？就是身兼父职。
You know, when we are young, obviously our mother would take care of us.
然后当我们还小的时候说，很明显的我们的母亲说会照顾我们。
Okay, and no matter what mistakes they have done or made, we need to make a decision. I'm going to take care of their lives when they grow older.
不管他们做了什么样的那一个错误啊，还是对我们做出什么伤害的好，我们都要做一个决定，就是说当他们年老的时候，我们都要照顾他。
And why do we do that? Because we love and we honor our God. We love and we honor our God.
那为什么我们这么做呢？因为我们爱，同时我们也尊重我们的神。
Okay, and we need to learn to imitate Jesus. You know, even the end, she's still thinking about his mother.
所以呢，我们应该向耶稣学习，然后哪怕是他生命的最后一刻，他还是挂念着他母亲。
Okay, so again, I'm not saying accepting their negative behavior. Okay, don't accept their negative behavior, but learn to love the person, not their sin. You can hate the sin, okay? That's okay, but love the person.
当然这边重申的就是我们不是叫你去接受他的那个缺点或者是他的罪，我们可以学习就是爱他。可是什么却恨罪。
Okay, isn't amazing? Jesus is so amazing. We can learn so many things from Christ.
我们发现到耶稣是不是很棒，然后很神奇呢？然后我们可以从他身上学习很多很多东西。
Okay, last two points will be very brief.
最后两点将会很短的。
Because we'll talk about husband more elaborately on another time.
然后因为呢，我们将会谈到丈夫。更深入的谈到丈夫，然后下一次。
Alright, so husbands, if you are around, are we around husbands?
Yeah, 丈夫们，我们还在吗？
How should you treat your wife as a mother?
然后我们怎么样跟对待身为母亲的我们我们的太太呢？
Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25, it says what?
以弗所书第五章第25节这边
Husband, love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her.
第二十五节，你们做丈夫的要爱你们的妻子，正如基督爱教会，为教会舍己。
You know, the Bible challenged the men, you know, the husband. You need to love the way love your wife, the way Jesus would love you.
所以，圣经里面挑战丈夫们，就是说。你们得爱你们的妻子，就好像耶稣爱你这样。
In most homes today, especially not just Asian homes, in most homes, guess who's the boss? Who loves to be the boss?
然后在家大部分的家庭里面呢，不管是亚洲还是外国的话，是吧？你猜啊，谁是啊家里面的那个老板？
Okay, who likes to put their feet up on the table, watch TV while the other person cook, do their computer game while the other person do dishes, play with their Facebook while the other person sweep the floor? Who likes to do that?
我问你啊，有谁偷懒是吗？在另外一个人在忙着啊烧菜的时候，是吗？会翘起那双脚在那边看电视机，又或者是啊，有谁会在那边啊玩啊玩电玩啊，或者是看 Facebook 啊？然后当另外一个人是吗，在忙着打扫屋子的时候
，You get them to be what the husband, you know? They party.
啊，叫啊，通常都是那个丈夫啦，然后就在那边偷懒。
Sometimes wife also lah, but majority is the husband.
啊，当然啊，老婆可能有时候啊，不过大部分时候是嘛，通常都是丈夫。
Okay, we'll talk more about it. But you know what's our problem? Sometimes we think our wife, they are Marvel, they are a character come out from Marvel comic. Super mother.
啊，有时候什么啊，我们啊，啊，把我们的太太说啊，当做好像超级女人呢。
And then, you know, we come home, we think, oh, I'm tired already. But mom, okay lah, extra strength. Don't know where they can get it from, but they can do it. They also got work, but never mind. They still have strength to cook, wash dishes, sweep the floor, do laundry. They are superwoman.
有时候丈夫啊回到来的时候啊，会觉得啊，我很累了，我什么都不想做了，然后。啊，当我们看到我们太太的时候，是吗？就跟讲啊，女人是吗？是超人来的。然后，哪怕他们有工作是吗？可是他们回到家，他们还是有那个超能力，继续的去做家务的。
Okay, your wives are not superwoman, right, women?
你的太太不是啊，超级女人。
They have the same amount of energy as you do. If you are tired, they are also tired.
然后他们跟你一样，就是说，他们有的那一个气力、体力是吧，跟你一样。如果你是累的话，他们也会累。
If you love their fun, they also love their fun.
如果你喜欢就是有玩乐的话是吧，他们也是喜欢玩乐的。
So why is it only you have fun and they do the work?
为什么呢？为什么只有你是吧可以去？玩乐，而他们却要做家务呢。
Okay, so husband, all right, take this point to heart. I'm not going to elaborate anymore, but another time I'll elaborate. But take it to heart. You know, husband, we need to love our wife as Christ loved the church.
所以丈夫们啊，我们要像耶稣爱教会、爱我们这样去爱我们的太太。
Okay, finally, last point.But also very brief because we'll talk about it this Friday.
然后最后一点呢，是很短的一点，因为我们这个星期五啊，将要继续谈。
Alright, this Friday we'll have a parenting class, amen.
那这个星期五我们将会有一个亲子课程。
Okay, for the youth, you have your mentoring time, I believe, right?
青少年们相信你们会有一个辅导时间。
Okay, singles, my wife will be will be teaching you guys.
单身呢，让我太太将会教导你们。
Single man, I guess you can come to my class. You can learn something as well.
单身的弟兄的话是吧？你们也可以参与我们这个亲子教育啊，也可以学习一些东西。
Okay, but anyway, the Bible says here, Proverbs 14 verse 1, Ephesians 6 4, the wise woman builds a house, but with her own hands, the foolish one tears it.
然后这边箴言书第十四章第一节呢，谈到智慧妇人建立家室，愚妄妇人亲手拆毁。然后我们跳到以弗所书第四章，以弗所书第六章第四节，你们做父亲的不要惹儿女的气。只要照着主的教训和警戒养育他们。
Okay, so easy as mothers. Because you love so deeply. Your love is so intense. Okay? And you accidentally, mistakenly, or whatever, exasperate your children.
那因为你对孩子们，因为母亲们对孩子们的爱是那么的重，所以有时候我们很容易的不小心，或者是错误的去惹恼我们的孩子。
Okay, because we women tend to be more fearful about the future, right? And because of your fear, your concern for your children, you tend to be what? Controlling and overprotective.
然后女生呢，通常都是对未来没有安全感，或者是有一些恐惧感的，也就是因为处于这一些惧怕还是恐惧感的话，是吗？我们都会对我们的孩子会显得比较控制欲比较强，又或者是过分保护。
Okay, or these are ways we exasperate our children. Sometimes we have too high standard about their education. We feel like their grades are never good enough, no matter what they get, unless they get 110.
Right. 又或者是我们有其他的那个方法上惹恼我们孩子，有时候我们对我们的要求过高，特别是对他们的那个学业那方面，然后不管他考的怎么样的成绩，话说话总是不够好，然后你总是认为他们永远的考不到110分。
Okay, or we are very punitive or negative, and sometimes we don't want to listen to their feelings. We tell them, don't tell me your excuse. I don't want to listen. Just do what I say. So we shut them down.
又或者是有时候我们是比较带有惩罚性的，又或者我们有太过的那个负面的，又或者有时候我们把他们的那个情绪。 完全封锁起来，不让他们就是表达他们的那个意见或是他们的感受。And
so, again, these methods were called, this interaction actually exasperated our children, even though our intention is pure and good.
然后我们会告诉我们孩子，你不要给我任何借口了，你照着我的方法去做，然后我们这一些互动是吗？ 会造成我们惹恼我们的孩子，然后影响到我们的亲子关系。Okay,
so parents, mothers, not just mothers, fathers also. Alright, we need to learn how to love and train our children with what? Healthy, loving, emotional connection and acceptance.
所以父母们，我们要学习，同时训练我们的孩子。 拥有就是健康的情绪上的那一个关系，还有接纳。
So this Friday, and then next month on the 16th, that Friday we'll talk about how can we learn to meet the core emotional need of connection and acceptance in our children so that they can feel loved, esteemed, and cared for.
所以呢，在来一个星期五和下个月的6月16号呢，我们将会有那个亲子课程，教导我们怎么样去满足孩子们的那个情绪上的核心需要，怎么样去让他们感受到我们爱和对他的那个接纳，以便他能够对自己有自信。
Okay, so in conclusion, mothers are special people, amen.
然后总结呢？ 母亲是很特别的
Okay, and no matter how your mom is like, we all need to learn to love and appreciate our mothers.
不管你的母亲是什么样的，然后我们都得学习就是去爱，同时去珍惜我们的母亲。
Okay, so we already talked about these points, so you can take a photograph if you want to remember. All right, learn to honor our mother in the Lord. Amen.
好，然后我们谈到这一些点呢，你可以就是拍个照片，然后总结呢就是我们学习怎么样去尊重我们的母亲，尊重我们的神。Okay,
one last point. If you have not already done so, make sure you tell your mother you love her very deeply from the heart, or you give her a text message if she's not around, okay, or buy her a little gift Okay, just show your appreciation. Alright? And amen.
如果你们还没有做到的话，记得在今天这个特别日子，对你的母亲说话，说我爱你。如果她不在你身边的话，可能打个电话，还是留个短信，告诉她有多爱你，让她觉得就是说，有人珍惜她。
Amen. All right. So now it's time for communion. So I'm going to pray for the bread and the wine. Okay, so let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much we can come together. Thank you that your scriptures, your Bible show us the right way. Father, we know that in life there's so much trouble, so much difficult things, you know, but yet you still love us. Teach us to learn to love and appreciate our mother on this special day. And, you know, and help us to learn to forgive if there's bitterness. And help us to learn to, in the long run, win our mother over to the Lord. We love you. Thank you for Jesus for dying on the cross and for his blood that was shed for our sins. We pray all this in the Son's name. Amen.